Welcome to my Sitecore Diaries, your ultimate guide to digital experience excellence, your go-to channel for all the things in Sitecore and .NET. I'm your host, Jitendra Ghanekar. I'm in Sitecore Technology MVP 2024. So today we are going to start a new series that is Sitecore JSS. So we will be doing the videos related to Sitecore JSS. So today is the first topic. So we'll start from the basic. We will see the basic concept of a headless architecture. So what is headless that we are going to see? So what is in this video? First of all, we will see what is headless. Then we will see what is traditional CMS and what is headless CMS. Then we will see the difference between these two by a real-time example. Then obviously we will see the different pointers where we will try to find out the difference between traditional and headless. Then we'll see how the basically a headless CMS works, and at the end we will see what are the benefits of headless CMS. But before starting to this content, I will request you to subscribe to the channel and click on a bell icon to get latest update. If you are liking the videos on my Sitecore Diaries, make sure to click on the like button, upvote this video and provide your comment via the comment section. So let's start today's topic, a headless architecture. So what is headless? So if you see any application, it will have a front end, that is your user interface, mobile application or any digital touch point, which is your front end. And there is a back end which will have a content, authoring UI, third party integration, etc. So basically your front end, which is like a head, from which you identify the website. So that is the reason it is called as a head. And you have a back end where it is called as a body. Okay, so then what is headless? So if you separate out your head from the back body, then just a body part you see here without the user interface, without any touch or digital touch point, that is your front end. So complete front end is not there. It is without the head, just a body. So that is called as a headless CMS, okay, which will contain only a content, authoring UI and third party integration. So what is headless? CMS without the front end, without a user interface, without a mobile application, without any digital touch point. Basically, there is no head. So that is called as a headless. And headless CMS will have a content, authoring UI, third party integration, etc. Now we talked about a traditional CMS. So how does the traditional CMS look like? Okay, basically it's a monolithic application which will contain what you see is what you get editor, then the administrator UI. So these are the two key component within the any CMS. Okay, so after that there might be a third party integrations. Your content will be stored in the CMS, so content will be there. Then you will have a front end application. So basically it's a tightly coupled. If you see, it's within the one application. It is a monolithic application which you will have. Obviously you will have a different servers, but your integration, like you will have a separate delivery server and separate CM server, but your application is the same. It is tightly bind. Okay, so this is your monolithic application, and this renders your different digital touch point, okay, like a desktop, laptop, any kiosk or a mobile, okay, by using some responsive mechanism like Bootstrap and other things. Okay, so this is how your traditional CMS look like. Okay, now in this, how does the headless CMS differs? Okay, so we'll see how the headless CMS differ. So it will have a, again we will have a what you see is what you get editor, or can be a data editor. It's now depend on what which kind of a CMS, which CMS you are using. Depending on that, you might have a just a data editor where you can just update your data, or you can have a what you see what you get kind of a editor. Like Sitecore has a experience editor in the headless also, so that will be there. then you will have a content. Obviously, it's a CMS, so it will have a content. Then you have an admin UI, so that is also a part of your traditional CMS. So that will also be here. It will do some administrative work. Then this is the new thing which will get added into the headless CMS, and it is a key part of the headless CMS. This is a differentiation between the traditional CMS and your headless CMS. The headless CMS deliver the content using the content APIs. So you will have a content APIs, and that will be depend on your type of application, type of a CMS which you are using. The content APIs differ, but all headless CMS will have a content API which will provide you a data in the different formats. At the same time, you might have a separate composable features which you can integrate with your CMS. Similarly, third party integration we can do, but those will be the outside your CMS. Okay, those are not integrated within the headless CMS, but it is outside. Okay, so that is also separated here. And then you will have your front end application, that is your header. Okay, that can be viewed have on the different technologies. Like for a desktop application, you might use a .NET Core. You might have a website which is built in the Next.js, and then there might be a mobile app. Okay, so all three technologies are different for the front end application. All these three mechanism are completely different. They are not depend on each other, but they are using the same content by using the content APIs. Okay, so we have separated completely a front end application. Okay, so tomorrow, if there is any change in your front end application, you want to use, say you have a .NET application, currently you have created your website in .NET Core, but tomorrow you want to use the Next.js or a React or Vue, you can build that application without changing anything in the headless CMS. Okay, so that is how your headless CMS look like. So the difference between the headless CMS and the traditional look wise you must have understand now. So let's take a real time example. Okay, so you have a frozen pizza in, you have brought from the market. So that when you bake it, it will be always a frozen pizza that you can get, but from the market you bring the different ingredient. Okay, and you have your own kitchen also. So for using this ingredient, you can make the pizza, you can make the pasta, whatever you want. Okay, so frozen pizza is something like your traditional CMS, whereas this part is your headless CMS, where you integrate the things and build whatever you want. So this your head, your visual representation can be different. You can have a pizza or you can have a pasta. So that is how the difference between the headless CMS and your traditional CMS. Now let's see a difference between traditional and headless CMS. Okay, so let's define first of all what is traditional CMS. A traditional content management system, that is CMS, the backend which will have a content management database and server side logic, and front end, that is contains a presentation layer, are tightly coupled. Okay, we have seen this last diagram that both the presentation layer, that is the front end, and the backend are tightly coupled. The CMS handles everything from content creation, storage, to rendering the website pages. That is very important, that it is also handle the rendering the website pages in the traditional CMS. Then if you talk about the headless CMS, the headless CMS on other hand decouples the backend from the front end. We have seen the example that it separates out your head from the body. The CMS handles content management and storage, but does not dictate how the content is presented. So in the traditional CMS, it also has a responsibility to render the website pages, but in case of headless CMS, that is not a part of your CMS. Instead, it provides a content via APIs, allowing any web front end, it can be a web, mobile or IoT, to consume it. Okay, so it provides the content via the APIs in the format which can be consumed by website, web application, mobile application, or IoT application. Now let's see different pointers, different points in the traditional CMS. We already seen traditional CMS is a tightly coupled architecture. It is front-end and back-ends are interconnected with specific template system. So in the Sitecore MVC, if you are building a website, you build the page template as well as a data template, and those are tightly bind, right? So page templates are required from the Sitecore to render the complete page, right? Then you have a single technology stack. So in the Sitecore CMS, you must have seen that both the front end and the back end, Sitecore CMS, MVC CMS, you must have seen the front end and back end use the same stack, that is the .NET. Easy of setup. It's very easy to set up. It's a normal .NET website in the Sitecore, so you can set up the Sitecore MVC. For traditional CMS, it is very easy to set up, especially for the non-developers. Limited flexibility. Now this point can be a debatable, okay, yeah, can be you can say it's a flexible one, but it can be debatable. Customization option can be limited, especially for a advanced feature of or integration. Performance limitation. Performance can be an issue as the system grows, with all layer potentially being affected by the increased load. So in the traditional CMS, performance can be an issue. Let's see what this headless CMS offer. Decoupled architecture, we already discussed this. It is a front end and back ends are independent. Flexibility in technology, this is very important here. So you can have a different front ends. Front end can be developed using a different technology. So your front end can be developed in .NET Core, you can be developed in next.js, it can be developed in the React, Vue, Angular, whatever. So there is no constraint on the front end technology. And also in future, if you want to change that, it's just your front end will change, not the back end. Greater customization, as I said in the that it can be a debatable thing, but yes, headless CMS from the front end point of view, it is more customizable than the traditional CMS. Scalability. Front end and back end can be scaled independently. Both are different applications, front end and back end. So you can perform the scalability for both the things separately. Content delivery. And this is also very important part. The content can be delivered to the multiple platforms from the single back end. And there is one more thing which you can utilize in the headless CMS, that your content itself can be a CDN. Okay. Like you use the experience agent Sitecore. So it can be a CDN also that will faster your website performance. So that is, these are the differences between traditional CMS and the headless CMS. Okay, how does headless CMS works? So we are going to see it detailed in this series, the how the headless CMS work, but we will just summarize it, just an overview how it works. So first of all, you have to create a contain, and it will be managed by the editor in the your headless CMS. It will be get stored in your repository, so content storage will be a part. Then you have to create the API. So this is a site, headless CMS will expose your content using the API exposure. Front end developer will build their front end with using their technology, and they can consume the CMS API, content API, okay, in their application. And at the end, you will have a consistent brand experience across all channels by using the same content API. So you're using the same content API for the multiple touch points. Okay. And also you can have the CDN also as a part of your content delivery. So this is how the headless CMS work. It's just an overview. We'll have a, we will, once we will go ahead with these series, you will understand all these points more in detail. Alright, we come to the last section of the video, that is the benefits of headless architecture. There are many have benefits which we can link, but what I feel is there are three important benefits which I am mentioning here. First is the improved developer experience. Developers can work on the front end or back end independently, which speed up the development. This is one of the highlight of the headless architecture, that your front end and the back end are separate. So then your developers are separate, they can work separately, and which will speed up your development also. The next is the future grooming. This is also very important for the headless architecture. As a new front-end technologies emerge, the backend doesn't need to significant change. So today it is a React, then the Next.js, then tomorrow it will something new will come. So in that case, you just need to change your front-end, not the back-end. So future proofing. And the third point is the enhanced user experience. Front-end developers can create more dynamic and interactive user interface. So it is more flexible. The UI is more flexible. So front-end developers can work on their own to reach the your user interface. So these are the three key benefits of a headless architecture. There are many you can mention, but for me, it's these three are the most important ones. So I'm mentioning here. Alright, we are done for today. This is the first video for this headless architecture, Sitecore JSS. Okay, it's a basic of a headless. This is a starting point, the first step of for the JSS. So if you like the video, please click on the like button. Do share this with your friends and colleague, okay, who want to understand the Sitecore headless. Until now, if you are not subscribed to the channel, then do consider subscribing to the channel and click on that notification bell to get a latest update from our channel. Thank you. Thanks for watching.